Welcome to Honest Book Reviews. If you are new to the channel, please subscribe. Today we will be reviewing The Delivering Happiness: A Path to Profits, Passion, and Purpose book by Tony Hsieh. And while that might have been fine, what Tony created was something much better, and much bigger. So don't mistake people having fun at work with a lack of focus, productivity, or seriousness. You may not be able to go to Las Vegas and go on a tour of Zappos, but you'll feel like you did. This book doesn't seek to tell anyone how to run their business, but it does encourage people to ask questions about how and why they do these things they do. He has proven that there is a different way to succeed in business and in life. It's not a how-to because every company needs to figure out what works for them, but there are fantastic ideas and ways to think about culture that are very different from your average business book. Forget what they told you in school and mark up this book so you can reference it. Hsieh engages the reader to want to know how and what it takes to be successful. A lot of the book is an autobiography of how Tony Hsieh has Zappos came to be, like how they have a library for employees to contribute or borrow, how over time it has grown. Recommends a lot of titles to the reader. A lot of them are mandatory reading for employees. First there are physiological needs, then there are safety security needs, then there are self-esteem, self-actualization. It's great entrepreneur story with a lot of insights, but this is not a story how to run and manage company. Great read. How far Tony went to make sure Zappos survived the dot-com crash is nothing short of extraordinary. It is proof that when you put people before profits, you can be incredibly successful. You have all you need to achieve what Zappos has done in the people around you. Here, Tony tries to cover it up, saying they had an understanding of culture value, and it was a win-win. Put simply, this book was an interesting conversation with Tony about his story, Zappos' story, and a bit of content around the practicalities of the Zappos culture. This is even more a look at what good can happen by identifying values and holding to them in any life's work. Tony gives the reader a wonderful look at what can happen in the workplace when people choose to identify and maintain a culture that works for the business and all workers. They are a well-oiled baseball machine, a culture, and a corporation with essentially one goal: keeping the fans happy. These are all important, but having a unified company culture and a focus beyond just staying in business and profitability is just as essential to a company's success. At one point, Hsieh suggests that service is to Zappos what hip and cool is to the Virgin brand. Bringing a World Series to Boston was only part of the plan for John Henry. Having Janet Marie Smith on board as Fenway's chief architect, Henry set his sights on improving the entire ballpark experience. With the addition of the monster seats, renovations to the inside and outside of the park, and a dedication to the farm system, and free agent signings, which have yielded more hits than misses, the Red Sox build their brand on being fan and family friendly. Fenway Park is more than a place to watch a good baseball team. It is, partly with the help of a good marketing team, America's most beloved ballpark. Hsieh, no expert on what it takes to build a lifetime of happiness given less than 3 decades of life. The first third of the book is a quite amusing tale of Tony's time at college, followed by his first job at Oracle. Tony's description of his time at Oracle provides insights into the life of young techies in Silicon Valley. The remaining two-thirds of the book explain the origination, development, and growth of Zappos. Tony Hsieh achieved happiness and success the same way the giants of Silicon: Gates, Jobs, Zuckerberg, etc., reached greatest, by seeking a higher purpose. More importantly, this is a good about how to seek out happiness, an enjoyable read. A definite must-read for everyone who's responsible for influencing others, regardless of whether it's a direct reports, peers, etc. The first two sections of the book focus on Tony's life from his childhood and time spent in college to his time building Linkshare, and then Zappos. The book itself isn't about great writing or anything except a stellar example of putting one's money where his mouth is, which Tony does. It would be an honor to coach clients who work at an organization such as Zappos. It's the new way to do business. Me gusto que el enfoque en los empleados y la cultura organizacional que trabajan para mantener a los empleados y por consiguiente clientes contentos. The last piece about personal happiness, though, is actually less fun because it feels more like a combination of all happiness theories than true stories. Zappos is an online retailer of shoes, clothing, bags, and handbags, housewares, and other products. It was more like death by a thousand paper cuts, or like the Chinese water torture, Tony writes. Drop by drop, Day by day, any single drop or bad hire was bearable, and not that big a deal. They built a resource library in the lobby with over 100 business and management books. Many of the books would eventually become required reading for our employees to help them pursue growth and learning, and Zappos would even offer classes to go over some of the more popular books. Eventually, they put it in writing and self-published their own culture book, editing only the typos, just allowing employees to tell it like it is. For a free copy of the culture book, just email the company and include your physical mailing address. Low tech as it may sound, our belief is that the telephone is one of the best branding devices out there. Jen, who explains their culture book, describes the sum total as the gestalt of Zappos. Daniel Pink in his book Thrive offers this explanation: boomers are the largest demographic cohort in most Western countries, as well as in places like Japan, Australia, and New Zealand. This book is an insightful summary of the Zappos way of doing business, and is definitely worth the read. This is the thing that everybody wants and achieved, but unfortunately others failed in doing it so because of many factors. Thank you for watching. Do not forget to subscribe and leave your comments below.